Hello everyone, the idea of this video is to try to help some of the users, owners of Sonic Mini 4K. I'm the owner of one of those machines, those are amazing machines, but they simply does not work out of the box directly. In many cases, there are a lot of people that just get the machine out of the box and make it work, but there are a lot of people having trouble to make it happen. And I believe it's maybe related with some batch of machines, or some machines are have some issues that prevent us to just use it straight out of the box, okay? But yeah, when you make it work, make it print properly, it produces amazing pieces. Like you see this guy here, very very detailed guy. I will post some pictures, more detailed pictures for you guys to see. This other orc here, super super sharp. But for you to get there, you need to follow a few steps, okay? And I will try to explain each of the steps that I followed to make it work. The first one, build plate, okay? When you first get your machine, you get with this build plate here, right? I think everyone knows it. But here's the deal. The thing is, this section here that holds the build plate is too tight. It comes too tight on the and it prevents you to proper level your build plate. So what's the solution? You unscrew all the screws here, remove that piece, and you need to bend it. I used my own arms, okay, just to try to put some force here to the sides, and try to bend it on a way to make this piece here move more freely and make the leveling easier in this case. Another thing that I've also done was I sanded a little bit this internal part, the internal part of this piece here. Because I don't know if it's possible for you guys to see, but yeah, it damaged the build plate if you do not do that, because of, again, it's too tight. So it's good to sand it to make it move more freely during the leveling, and do that will avoid you in the less problematic case not having better leveling. In the worst case, you can break your screen, okay, with that. So yeah, do that. Second point is these build plates do not come sanded, okay? You need some of this roughness here on the surface to make the prints to stick better to the build plate, and it's not come pre-sanded from the factory, so you need to do that by yourself. Some machines already comes with this with sandpaper like this one. It's an 80 grit sandpaper. Mine did not come with it. I had to buy it. And also you need to follow some instructions that from a video that Phrozen published on their channel. I will link down below for you guys to help you. So the idea is basically put your build plate like that and sand it in one direction only, okay? So that helps to increase a lot your adhesion to the build plate, okay? So after that, I still continue to have some failures even after leveling, after sand my build plate. And another problem that was reported for some users, and I will show you the machine here, is this black tape around the screen. Some users reported, and I think it was my case too, that this tape was interfering on the leveling, okay? When the build plate goes down to home, I think depending on the position of this tape, it just interferes on the leveling. I don't know if that happened or not, but in my case, I just removed it and adjusted it in order to make sure that the build plate does not touch it at all. Okay, it does not interfere on the leveling. And yeah, I've done that to and again, I believe it improved my my success rate. The other thing was related to the FEP. The first FEP that came with the printer pre-installed on my VAT, it just it was just destroyed by so many fails. So I think just from the first printing, which is the test print that comes on the USB, my FEP after this print, my FEP already had like a puncture or some defective on it, and I believe it was from this print. And after that, it was just a matter of some other fails to make the FEP get destroyed. Anyway, I changed it first for an Elegoo one that I had here, and I'm a regular FEP film with 0.15 millimeters, if I'm not wrong. It's a very, it's a thin FEP. Normally the FEPs are from 0.2 to and above, so yeah, and below, so 0.15, it's okay. And yeah, it kind of worked, but I still had some issues with some specific types of models. Some supports just did not work properly, and I don't know why. And I just came with another solution that worked for me and worked for a lot of people out there, which is I bought the EPAX nFEP solution. Okay, I ordered it on Amazon. I think it's $24 for 3 sheets of this FEP, and I installed it, and yes, now I can tell you after all these steps that my printer is working fine. I'm not experienced that much of that many fails anymore. I think my success rate now are above maybe 80-90%, and in the case that it not work normally is the supports or something, that it's user error in this case. And in this case, yes, there's no problem with the machine. It's difficult to calibrate the machine, okay, because yeah, you need to always print some tests before and check your resin exposition, things like that. It takes some time. But after you reach those sweet spot, it works fine. The other thing that I noticed on this printer, and maybe that's only relevant for those who already have another printer. If it's your first printer, you will not notice that. But I compared with my other printer. My other printer is a Photomono, and I noticed that the light source of this printer is weaker than the light source of the Photomono, and I've run several tests, dozens of tests, same model, same resin, same everything, of course with different exposure tests according with each of the machines, and my photo mono with specific resins that I use here needs only 1.2, 1.3 seconds per layer in case of normal layers. The same resin on the Sonic Mini 4K needs like 2.8, 3 seconds, sometimes even more, okay? The light source is, I don't know, I cannot say it's bad. Maybe the other one is, it's way better than it. So maybe it's the screen. The other printer is a 2K screen. We don't have many other 4Ks. In fact, we don't have any other small 4K screen to compare, right? So maybe the thing is related with the density of pixels or anything like that, that makes the light goes through more difficult for the light to go through. But yeah, it's, you need to take that in consideration. So bear in mind that this hype of 1 second layer, 1.5, even 2 seconds, I don't know if it's that much possible, but yeah, maybe with specific resins or anything like that. With the ones that I use, no. Even the Aqua 4K resin, yeah, I could get good results after the nFEP installation, but before that, no. But yeah, that's it. I hope it helps you guys to deal with this machine. And yeah, stay safe. See you next time. Bye.